Hey guys, hope you're having a good day. By now I assume most of you have seen the epic conclusion of the Clone Wars. The last four episodes were intense, emotional, and beautifully made. I don't understand how Dave Filoni isn't in charge of more Star Wars projects, but I hope this shows how amazing he is at storytelling and creating in general. For this video, we're going to be telling our interpretation of how Rex eventually meets up with the Wolffe and Gregor and Rebels. We know they eventually get together, but we don't know how. This is obviously just speculation and not canon, so hopefully a definitive answer is given sometime in the future. First, we'll hop into Rex and Wolf meeting up, as we think that would happen first. And then we'll get into Rex and Wolf finding Gregor. If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe to support the channel. Hope you enjoy, and let's get into the video.
It has been a few days since Order 66 took place. Commander Wolf has been tasked by the newly found Empire with searching the planet Othal for any leads to surviving Jedi. Meanwhile, Rex and Ahsoka must stop to the nearest system to refuel, which happens to be Lothal. As Wolf searches the blocks of Lothal, he reminisces of the times he had with his brothers, but then his mind refocuses on hunting down any Jedi. While patrolling the city, he suddenly hears his name whispered behind him, and for a brief moment he thinks he sees his brother, Captain Rex. He's then dragged into one of the homes and knocked unconscious. Both Rex and Ahsoka know they must get off this planet quickly with the clones searching the area. Rex lays Wolf onto a table inside the home while Ahsoka prepares a medical droid located inside. Rex is filled with hope to save one of his brothers after seeing so many perish over the last few days. Ahsoka places her hands on Wolf's head and says, "I'm one with the Force is with me," repeatedly as she helps locate the inhibitor chip inside Wolf's head. The medical droid begins a procedure to remove it as Rex stays motionless with anticipation. Once the procedure is finished, Rex stands by Wolf's side and says, "Wolf, are you alright?" Wolf replies, "Yeah, I think so. It's great to see you, Rex. I thought you were dead." Rex then explains what happened as Wolf sees Ahsoka in the corner and reaches for his blaster, but then remembers the Jedi aren't really the enemy. Suddenly, there is pounding on the door from the clone searching the block. Rex, Wolf, and Ahsoka escape out a ladder onto the roof to thank the Bridger family for being so helpful in their time of need. As they get back to their ship, Rex and Wolf wish they could have saved all their fellow brothers from serving the corrupt Emperor, but there is just too many to do anything. They leave the planet with at least one positive of Rex saving a longtime friend in Commander Wolf.
Rex and Wolf then take some time to realize the situation they're in. They want to save other clones, but know it's just not possible to save the whole Grand Army of the Republic. Rex wants to get in contact with clones who are low profile and who have been off the grid for some time. He first thinks of the deserter he met on Salakumi named Cut Laquan, but after contemplating going to him for shelter and help, he thought of Cut's children. He wasn't like Rex, and now wasn't the time to drag him into a new war. Wolf then remembered the story of Clone Commander Gregor, a heroic clone who went missing in action on Abifar. He could still be out there, and a low profile planet would be a good place to lay low for a while. Rex and Wolf set their course for Abifar and went on their way. Once on Abifar, the clones spent several rotations trying to get a lead on Gregor's whereabouts, with no luck. Finally, however, after finding his old boss, they were successful. It took some persuasion in the form of credits, but he finally told the troopers where Gregor was. It turned out that Gregor had yet another coma after his last stand against the Separatists. He was lucky to be alive, and also the fact that he didn't lose his memory this time. Borgus had dragged his unconscious self back to his house months ago to heal, and he hadn't even woken up until recently. "So where is he, Borkus?" Rex said harshly. Borkus responded, "He's safe in his home healing. Don't worry, I'll bring you to him." It wasn't a far walk to Gregor's home, as they arrived rather quickly. Rex opened the door and said, "Hello, I'm Commander Rex, former soldier of the Grand Army of the Republic. However, there isn't really a Republic anymore. That's why we came here to find you." "How do you know who I am? How did you find me?" Gregor said. Rex then replied, "Well, the whole Grand Army of the Republic knows of your sacrifice. What you did that day is one of the bravest things I've ever heard of. I knew there was a chance I'd find you here, and I'm just glad we got lucky for once." Gregor replied, "I just want you to know I'm not a deserter, Commander. I was planning on returning to the Republic as soon as I healed, but you're telling me there is no Republic any longer?" Rex sighed and said, "Yes, a chip was input into all of us when we were born, to one day destroy the Republic and the Jedi with it. Both Wolf and I took out our chips, and we can take out yours as well. What if we use your medical droid to take out your chip?" he said. Gregor was reluctant at first, but for sure didn't want to be brainwashed by some chip inside his brain. He was manipulated by Borgus for years, and wasn't going to let anything or anyone have control over his mind. Rex then set up the medical droid, laid Gregor back down, and began the procedure. The chip was successfully taken out, but Gregor sustained minor brain damage along the way. This would cause him to have some strange mannerisms in the future, as seen in Star Wars Rebels. So, after resting for some time in Gregor's home, the three clones set course for the desolate planet of Silos, where they would lay low for some time, cruising along on their sand crawler.
Alright, we hope you enjoyed our take on how we think Rex may have met up with Gregor and Wolf. Also, we don't actually know how it has happened yet, so hopefully we will learn this in some form. But this is just how we think it could have happened, so comment any theories you have below. Also, leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more Star Wars videos. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.